Fabian? There. Yeah. Okay, I see him.
The male is over there.
And she's ahead of him.
I've come to know Gorongosa's lions very well over the past 5 years. They are among the most incredible species I've ever worked with.
Paola Bouley is on the front lines of a battle to bring back lions to Gorongosa National Park in Mozambique. This terrestrial ecosystem was once home to an incredible diversity of wildlife and vegetation. But a very long civil war in Mozambique devastated the park.
This country endured 16 years of civil war. So we lost about 95% of our large mammals in a very short time.
Most of the lions were gone, and the prey they depended on.
After the war, recovery began, although slowly.
The prey started to rebound, but
we found that lions weren't making such a strong comeback. So we started the Lion Project in 2012, and our research is really focused on understanding why.
The balance of predator and prey is critical to a sustainable ecosystem.
No one had ever done research on this population. We knew nothing.
In order to study the lions, they first have to find them.
That's a very difficult thing to do in a park like this that has very few roads, very high grass, and is really wilderness. So it took us a few months to actually get close to the lions.
Besides tracking on foot, Paola's team uses camera traps.
A little camera trap gets deployed usually on a tree, and if an animal walks in front of that, it triggers the camera. We often capture very cool behavior. Cubs will come up to cameras and start to chew on them. We've had lionesses come up to the camera and roar at us.
The next important tool for studying the lions is a satellite GPS collar.
So those collars changed everything.
You can get more in the open here.
Paola's team discovers the main reason why lions are not thriving. They're getting caught in illegal snares and traps.
The research was showing 1 in 3 of our lions were either being killed or maimed in snares. And we began to focus on ways to reduce that risk to lions.
The war was over, but the human impact, including hunting and killing lions, kept the ecosystem from full recovery.
Using lion patrols, which are trained rangers out in the fields, they're basically sweeping an area clean of these devices that lions and other wildlife are getting trapped in. During the peak of the crisis, we were having about 8 lions snared a year. Over the past 12 months since we've intervened with our conservation strategy, we've only had 1 lion snared. So that's a massive reversal in the trend. Wildlife has recovered incredibly across the park. You can't go anywhere without seeing an abundance of wildlife. Here, we can make a difference. By understanding what's going on with lions and pushing the conservation, that's an opportunity of a lifetime for this park.
The health of any ecosystem depends on the balance of biodiversity, the wildlife, the plants, the natural resources. Gorongosa's restoration is a model for the world.
The idea was to recover this park, the tourism, the ecology, the communities living around the park, and create an example of what could be if people put their hearts and minds together to restore an ecosystem.